I'm a misfit till I die, and I'm never changing. Just a young boy trying to find a way.
It's not how good you are, it's how good you want to be.
They say, carpe diem, you gotta seize the day.
It's not how good you are, it's how good you want to be.
Almost 3 years ago, we told the story of Social Club. Well, needless to say, a lot has happened since then. Of course, you can hear that original testimony at testimonystories.com. With the help of the Misfit Gang, a nickname their fans gave themselves, they have charted on billboards several times and have sold thousands of copies of their albums. And we have to mention their packed and sold-out concert tours. Yes, over the past few years, Social Club has made a name for themselves, and they did it all independently and by the grace of God. If you don't know, Marty and Fern make up the duo.
What's going on? It's Marty.
Hey, what's going on? It's Fern, and you're listening to Testimony, a musician's story. Check it out.
Last year, fans got to know the duo individually when they each released solo projects. Marty dropped Marty for President, then Fern dropped 68 and Douglas.
Let me be honest. To be honest with you, the EP, that was fun because people see Social Club and they're like, they see the diversity. Look, how do these guys, how could they rap together? How the heck did you guys meet, this and that? But when you hear the EPs and you hear the stories and then you hear Social Club, you start to understand. You know, we were able to show our story. Martin was able to paint 100% of what he wanted to paint. You know what I'm saying? I was able to paint 100% of what I wanted to paint. When we get to Social Club, we have thoughts and we combine ideas together. And it's a beautiful thing because we're both humble and we both, you know, adhere to each other's thoughts. And that's a whole nother project. You know what I'm saying? Like, ask Marty. It's only God because, you know, a lot of groups will probably, you know, not agree all the time. A lot of groups will probably be like, no, I want to do this, I want to do that. But me and him, we have never gone through that. You know what I'm saying? Like,
we've laid the foundation for that. Number one, we have a similar vision. The vision is to, number one, work hard. The vision, I mean, your life is either going to be a design or it's going to be by default. So if you go by default, I feel like more problems are going to come about. It's like, your life, if you go on default, you might take more breaks or chill out or not do stuff. And when you have a design, when you have a vision, it's almost as if like you're always working with the same mind. And so I feel like for us, I heard this interview with Ludacris, and he was talking to him and his manager. He's like, my manager found me when I first started. He was on the radio with me, and we just continued through life. He's like, we don't even have contracts. He's like, we just honor each other. We respect each other. He's like, I know that's very rare in the game, but that's what we're doing. And I feel the same way a lot when I think about Fern and myself. It's like, we have the same vision. You know, we both work. We both kick butt. We both do what we have to do. We both have fun at what we do. We both honor each other, respect each other. There's never like outbursts of like, I hate you. And like, I don't know who does that. That's weird to me. Like, we're grown men and we have to honor each other. The Bible says, like, work as hard as you can to, like, love each other and give honor and you know, like, all these great things that the Bible says that we should do according to, like, each other, like, love each other. And we exercise those in our life. And because we do that, that's why when we meet misfits, we show them that same love, that same honor, because it's already what we're doing. Like, it's the culture of what we have. So when we meet somebody we don't know, they're going to fall into the design that we've created that God's put in our heart, which is honoring and loving and hugging. And like, we're just people who love people. We love God. And so I feel like our love for God has given us such a fuel to love people and to like do whatever we have to do to like reach somebody. And I think that people think that it's all just, you know, accident or this is what happened. Like, no. A lot of this is coming to prayer. A lot of this is coming together and just being like, what do we want to do? What do we want to accomplish? Like, this is just a God thing. So I really believe that our life and what we're doing, I mean, right now we're working on a mission statement of just everything together, just to be like, hey, listen, this is what we want Social Club to look like. Whether we're together or not, like, at least we know the vision, we're attached to the vision, and we can always exercise that wherever we go. So it's by design, it's not by default. So smile. Oh,
To hear the full story and a complete track listing, visit testimonystories.com or subscribe to our podcast on iTunes, TuneIn, Google Play, or Stitcher.
In my lifetime, I've been out of my right mind, with nothing left, no lifelines, just wishful thinking in my rhymes. And my kids are soaring how time flies, my eyesight set way past the sky, cause I've probably been on 10,000 flights, and the first 5,000 I was petrified. When you know God's real, you settle down. This song is nothing but motivation in a time where real is a dying breed. Though there ain't none me, I want unity. Everybody knows ain't no I in team. From now on we all shine like diamond rings, and we won't stop till the whole world sings. This song about hope and the love God brings. I tell them the plan's always been unified. We all fall short, it's just you and God. To me this song is more than lines, cause I could've died like four times, but I didn't, so I know there's a plan. Differences this time, took the Lord by the hands. Deviate no man, I'm part of the program. Now please all stand and tell them we all can.
Living it up, aren't you?